So welcome to the vote. I'm here with Amazi and with Neil Cannon. We're going to be discussing 5G, which could be rolled out in Brighton, or the government are looking to roll it out in Brighton. And I know that you're closely involved in this. So maybe if you just talk, start off by talking about a bit about your backgrounds, maybe Amazi first.
Yeah, I'm a vital development facilitator. So I use dance to heal the body. I run a cleaning business, successful cleaning business in Brighton. So I'm a business owner.
Yeah.
And I have my concerns on this new technology. And I'm a mother of a 9-year-old. I've been aware of 5G and the dangers of 5G for quite a lot of years. And I've been worrying about it and quite concerned. And it's very close to actually the infrastructure being built.
Yes.
And I'm quite concerned for my community, for my business as well, because I'm all for technology. So I want to systemize my business, and I love technology and the way it's set up. But knowing that it's going to be hurting the health of my child, I'm really concerned. So that's why I'm here today.
Yeah. And Neil?
So my background is I've been in the health and healing space for the last 7 years. Since 2015, I've been helping people reverse all kinds of illnesses by getting to the root cause. So I help people free themselves from illness, pain and medication. I wrote a book called The Vitality Secret. And yeah, my specialty is helping people get to the root cause. So yeah. I'm really about healing the body, helping the body heal from the inside out.
Yeah.
And I understand that EMFs, current levels of EMFs, are causing a lot of harm already. And then we're about to be... have that already toxic load added to by 5G.
So I know EMF being electronic magnetic frequency?
Electromagnetic fields, yeah.
Fields, yeah. And that these are what all phone masts emit EMFs, right?
Currently, yes.
And this is going to be our main topic of discussion today, because it's what these EMFs do to humans, right, is what we're concerned with. So should we just start off with 5G? A lot of people might have heard about 5G, probably the Hawaii issue, which we're not going to go into today, but people are hearing about what is 5G? Why is there a rush to market? What does 5G do? What are the proposed benefits of it?
So 5G is really fifth generation mobile phone networks. It's a much faster speed, upload and download speed. They're promising, you know, telecom companies are promising much faster download speeds, more connectivity for the Internet of Things. So it's basically faster, and it's the next generation above 4G. So you've got 2, 3, and 4G, which each of those got higher in speed, to put it simply. Yeah. 5G is increasing the speed and power and frequency, using much higher frequency with much smaller waves, which are actually going to cause further harm. So 2, 3, and 4G have already been proven to be harmful for the body. They cause cell and DNA damage. And 5G is taking it up a whole new level. That's what I'm concerned about.
Yes.
And many people are concerned about in the holistic space.
And I know there's been two proposed sites for 5G masts in Brighton so far. I know one of them's just above Bright Marina. So what should people be concerned about with 5G then? Because a lot of people think, well, we want 5G because we want to get access our data faster, you know. Does it mean there's less masts around? Are we going to be taking down the old infrastructure for 2, 3 and 4G?
That's a really good question, because none of the old infrastructure is going to come down, and some of that will be used for 5G, but it's going to be added to, and there's going to be additional cell towers built over the years. I think currently they're going to use as much of the original structure as they can, and then it's going to be added to. So what do we need to be concerned with? Well, I think people need to become familiar with the fact that current levels are already causing damage.
Yes.
And there are about 6,000 peer-reviewed studies that demonstrate its dangers, and they're actually being ignored. So I think it's really worthwhile getting familiar with that. Typical kind of side effects for current levels of EMFs are headaches, nausea, tinnitus is one, you know, the more kind of mild symptoms, not being able to focus, brain fog. So very subtle things, depression, anxiety, it's very subtle at the start. But what we now know is that these EMFs actually cause cell and DNA damage. So we're basically made up of about 50 trillion cells. If you talk to cellular biologist Bruce Lipton, we're made up of 50 trillion cells. By the way, this guy was cloning stem cells before it became cool. So he knows a lot about what creates cells and what fuels them and what causes harm. And these EMFs are causing harm to the cells. So that's what we need to be concerned yes. with. And they've been, because they cause cell damage, we can link that to any kind of dis-ease imaginable. You can get yep. cancer, neurodegenerative decline, you know, it could be skin conditions. It's kind of going to get your weakest link.
Yes.
So wherever you're weakest genetically, should we say, probably the easiest way to explain it, that's where it's going to first yes. display its effects.
Yeah.
But it can be very subtle first.
And you have concerns, Amazigh, about this as well. So what are your concerns about 5G? Because Nils has outlined some of the health effects there. So obviously you're raising a child, aren't you? So that's
yeah. funny. Yeah, well, my concerns as a mother and as a business owner is whether I'm actually going to be healthy enough to run my business. Yeah. You know, healthy enough to look after my child, and whether my child is going to be healthy enough to live the life that I want her to live. You know, also the fact that it's going to affect our environment and our birds and our insects. You know, there's birds dropping down dead in Switzerland now because they've rolled it out and they're bleeding on the floor. You know, it's something that has not been tested, and that's my concern about it.
Yes.
And also the fact that neighbourhoods are completely unaware of it.
Yeah.
You know, they're thinking that climate change and, you know, climate change and Brexit are oh so much more important than this. And actually, I feel that this is part of the green that we are wishing to have. Because, you know, it's going to affect our surroundings,
yeah.
not other parts of the world. It's actually going to affect our community and very soon. And that is why I'm very concerned about it.
Yeah. So, Neil, so where has this been rolled out so far? Because we're one of the first cities, are we not, to have this
yes.
technology, right?
And Glastonbury, various parts of London. Can I just pick up on something that Amazigh
yes.
said is very,
yeah,
very
sure.
important? There has been no biological safety testing at all. There has been, and coming back to your earlier question, there's been a massive race to market.
Mm.
And one can hypothesise that there's been a race to market because almost to supersede the importance of biological safety testing.
Mm.
I mean, can you imagine a car manufacturer launching a make or model of car without any brake testing, any emission testing, anything like that to prove that it's safe? None of that has happened. There's categorically not a single test that has proven 5G to be safe, or even current levels of EMFs to be safe.
Yes.
And it's been completely bypassed somehow.
What about 4G? Has there been...
No.
Right.
That's the thing. So it's very interesting because this has woken me up, actually, in the last kind of couple of months, because I've been familiar with EMFs for a few years.
Yes.
And it's kind of like my tolerance has kind of gone with it and just accepted it. But it's because 5G is just a whole new level.
Yes.
You know, trees are coming down in Sheffield. It's been tested in Sheffield. Trees are coming down because these frequencies don't pass through trees. You know, as Amazigh said,
yeah.
it's causing harm to wildlife, to insects and bees. You know, all these studies are out there. And it's just really quite an interesting awakening topic to be
yes.
getting involved in.
And let's just be clear, so it's the EMFs, the electromagnetic frequency,
yeah.
that's the, and it's those, it's that's it's so powerful, right, which
yeah.
is causing all the damage. So
yes.
it's not something you can see, is it, really?
Exactly.
You'll see a mast there, but you can't see the damage.
You can't see it.
Precisely.
Yeah,
precisely.
But the symbol of yeah. the wireless, you know, it's kind of, it's going zzz, it's actually doing something.
Yes.
You can't hear the sound, but your body is feeling it, you know?
Yeah.
And it's the same as flocks, you know, like birds. Birds, they have their own direction. They have their own internet. That's why they synchronize so beautifully
yeah.
when we see them in the pier, you know? Mm. And these electromagnetic fields are going to distract them from their direction. So therefore, it's going to affect the flocks as well. So it's serious, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
It just made me think of something. When you put, I'm just going
to
bounce off of
what
you say.
That's good. We
but
need
you know,
bounce.
Talking about the you know the birds and how they you know migrate
yeah.
and fly to those fields, their own fields. When you put a cell phone next to a petri dish of sperm, something very interesting happens. And anyone can carry out this experiment, by the way. If you don't believe any of the literature out there, because I've been accused of sharing quackery stuff and pseudoscience, and I'm just like, look, guys.
Yeah.
You can well, you can cut through all the BS if you like. Am I allowed to say this?
Yeah,
you
could BS. Yeah.
And do your own experiments. You can actually see what happens with your own blood, with your own sperm sample. You can say, you can get hold of someone in your network and go, look, if someone got a microscope, I'd like to carry out a blood sample and a sperm sample and see what happens when I put my phone next to my blood sample or sperm sample. So tons of studies have been carried out on sperm to see what happens when they're exposed to these EMFs. And something extraordinary starts to happen. They start swimming in all different directions. Their motility drops, mobility drops, their DNA is damaged, their mitochondrial damage, that's the energy part of the cell. All of this damage has been proven already scientifically, but we can all do this ourselves as well if we actually want to.
Okay, we'll leave it there for now. Join us for the second half. We're going to be talking a lot more about 5G in the second half, so join us then. So welcome back to the VAP. I'm here with Amazee and with Neil Cannon. We're talking 5G. It was being rolled out in Brighton. Do we have any idea of the timeline for the rollout in Brighton at all? I know there was planning applications recently for there's two sites in Brighton, but we're one of the first cities, aren't we? So what, is there a time span for this?
I'm not sure about a time span. I know that I am part of a community group that have been writing to the MPs.
And that's Brighton Hove.
Brighton and Hove.
5G free.
5G free, yeah. So you can find all the facts there, and you can find letters to MP that have been designed so people can do it nice and easy. But hang on, what was the question you were asking me?
The first one is about the timeline.
Oh, yes, the timeline, yeah. I'm not sure. I know that they've been writing to the MPs and there has been a bit of awareness there. I think they're planning on it now. I think there's plans.
There's plans.
So there's not much of a timeline.
Yes. So what can people do then? Have you been involved in campaigns up in London?
Yes. I mean, prior to Glastonbury, I started a bit of a campaign to halt that because there's a company, mentioning no names, that's about to roll out 5G on, you know, test it on 210,000 people at Glastonbury, which I thought was a really bad idea. Mm. That's any biological safety testing. I mean, the whole thing's a bad idea anyway.
So yeah.
Putting it mildly. So I was on a bit of a campaign to have that halted, so I was writing to, just like Amazee, kind of council members, Glastonbury officials, EE officials, like the CEO of... I must mention a couple of letters. Anyway, we can take action by writing to people. We can take action by writing to our local authorities, our local councils. We can express our concern. We can organise meetups for, you know, in our local regions to really spread awareness of this. And the more that we can actually take it upon ourselves to get educated in this, I think the better.
Yes.
So in terms of, like, protecting ourselves, there's a lot we can do in that, on that regard as well. There's lots of shielding that we can do to, you know, protect ourselves from...
Because there are solutions, because some people listening out there, they might live near Bright Marina, for example. So what can they do? If they can't stop the mask going up, what can people do instead?
Yes. So one of the best things...
Lawfully.
So one of the best things we can do is we can get protective gear, for example, protective underwear.
Yeah.
You know, protective headgear, protective... It might look a bit odd, but if it's going to be right next to your house...
So dress up like RoboCop.
Yes, or like, you know, those... Yeah. What are they called? Those giants, those huge suits. Those...
I have no clue.
Those biological protective gears. Yeah. You can wear one of those, but obviously...
You're not going to be doing that every day.
but there are companies...
Are there practical things that you can...
Yeah, there are companies rolling out protective gear that you can actually wear underneath your clothes. There's a company called Omnia that I'm now involved with. You can actually put these stickers on your phone, on any electrical devices, which actually protect you from the fields that are emitted from these current levels of EMFs. You just want to become kind of more aware of your exposure and look for companies creating clothes, garments, protective shields as well against the EMFs. And do your research, because there's, you know, you want to get the high quality stuff, not stuff that's being just rolled out without any testing. Look for testing. Look for clinical trials of tests that have been done. But ultimately, you want to just be... Faraday cages as well are being built. These are cages that you can actually put over your bed. And some people I know in London are doing this already. There's a whole biohacking community I'm involved with in London, and people are getting these Faraday cages to literally surround their beds, which protect your bed from all these EMFs.
Yeah.
Although it is said that 5G is going to be much harder to protect ourselves from that perspective. But there are definitely things that we can do to protect ourselves.
You can use crystals as well.
Yes.
There's specific crystals that you can hold. And you can just do earthing, just going to the park and actually putting your feet on the ground. That will also kind of avoid the magnetic fields to affect your body as much. So if you do that daily, just having that connection with Mother Earth is going to be super important. But I would say the most important thing is, if we want to stop this, as well as creating awareness, I think it's really important to basically say change your telephone company, or just say no, I don't want 5G.
Yeah.
And if we take action, then those telecom companies, you know, they won't be able to do anything if we don't want the 5G. If we say no, I don't, because the thing is, you're also going to have to buy a 5G phone.
Absolutely.
And you're going to have to be paying 70 quid a month instead of 40 quid a month. So basically, we're paying for the infrastructure.
Yes.
That's how it's going to go. So, you know, do we really need a faster internet? I mean, I think the way we're living now is inhumane. It's at a very fast speed as it is anyway. We have children with anxiety.
Yeah.
We're suffering the consequences of technology already. Now, how much faster do we need to go?
Yeah.
You know?
The health effects of 5G might not be immediately apparent because it could be...
Exactly.
Because you wouldn't know it was related to a phone.
That's the thing. It's a very slow process. Unless you have electro-hypersensitivity, which a lot of people do have these days.
Yeah.
I've got personal friends of mine who literally can't be in a Wi-Fi environment. They have to walk out.
Yeah.
That's current levels of Wi-Fi. If you're in these buildings with all these flats with different Wi-Fi routers everywhere, imagine how... Do you ever look on your phone, you see all these different networks?
Mm.
We need to become familiar with that and just detach ourselves from that environment as much as we can. Yeah, I just want to second what Amazee said then. We can say no to 5G phones. Absolutely don't get a 5G phone. I'd say boycott the companies that have already launched 5G, because they're the equivalent of the car companies rolling out cars without any testing.
Yeah.
The biggest thing we need to know is no biological safety testing. No tests have proven it is safe. It has been proven categorically to cause cell damage and DNA damage. That's the makeup of life form. So it degrades the cells quite slowly. And you can, although you can see some imaging where it happens very, very quickly, but the effects, the symptoms in the body might be delayed. It could be a few years before you get a brain tumor, for example. And then obviously it'll be blamed on other stuff.
Yes.
But we just need to be familiar with this, and particularly with children as well. There's all these devices now that are being created for toddlers in cots to detect whether they're crying or whether they've even, you know, soiled their nappy. There's gadgets now that you can put inside nappies to see if they've been soiled, so the parents don't have to be a parent anymore.
Yeah, basically.
It's just absurd, because all of these technological advances are going so fast without any due care for people's health.
Yes, yeah.
So, and we need to actually get educated in this. We need to take our own power back, find out what's actually happening with all these EMFs, carry out our own research. Might even want to do, you know, what I suggested earlier, blood sample, sperm sample, or get someone near you to do that so you can actually have the confirmation. We need to get educated and not bury our heads in the sand on this issue. I think it's a really important thing to get
and also, just to add to that, the concern is that, you know, all of these little devices that we have in our house, you know, we even have, like, our smart TVs and we have our smartphones, you know, there's ovens and microwaves coming up, and it's all going to link to the same 5G network.
Yeah.
So when you start to get sick once the infrastructure is put in place, you're not going to be able to step back from that. So that's also really important to mention, you know, and I think also 5G it's not like the normal internet where you can just switch it off. Is that right? It's just going to be running all the time. You're not going to be able to switch it off. I switch off my internet. Sorry, I do switch it off at night because I do get I sleep better, and I'm quite sensitive to the Wi-Fi. So, but the fact that I'm not going to be able to switch it off, and I do not have the option to switch it off if I want to in my own house, is also very worrying.
Yeah.
Why won't they give us the option?
Yeah.
On the one point about that, with 5G smart meters, absolutely say no to that.
Mm.
Like, absolutely.
What's
say
a 5G
no.
smart meter?
It's to measure the electronics in the house.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's to replace your current meters.
Yeah.
I believe for gas and electricity.
Yeah, but it's everything is going to run under that.
Yeah, so everything's, it's like controlling the usage of everything. And they emit really powerful, toxic EMFs. Mm. And there's a 1 minute video on my Facebook page, in fact, it's all over the social media, but it's just a 1 minute video that shows exactly what happens to your cells when exposed to these smart meters within like, a meter or something. Mm. Within less than a minute, it shows precisely what happens to your cells.
Yeah.
And you can't argue with that imagery.
No.
Yeah.
You just can't. And then, of course, if you want to argue with it, just go and do your own experiment. But absolutely say no to 5G smart meters or to smart meters.
Okay, just before we finish up, is there a safe level of kind of how close you have to be to a 5G? If you're 5 minutes away, that's different to if you're living right under a mast, right?
It is. It is different. It's just I wouldn't say there is a safe level. You just want to be as far away from it as you can.
Yeah.
And protect yourself if you can. Get yourself protective gear. Yeah.
The thing is, it also depends on the volume of it. It
yes.
depends on how much they use. So on the this morning we were looking at the EE website, and do you want to say it was mentioning that what did it say?
Basically, the current levels got up to about 2.6 gigahertz in terms of frequency. That's 4G, and they're going to take this up to 3.2, but it could go up to 26 gigahertz, even higher in America. But right now they're rolling it out at 3.2 gigahertz. But they claim right now in 2019. They're not going to be using these millimeter waves.
Okay.
And there's a whole other added bit of content about that, which I won't talk about now. But what they're saying is that it's not going to be rolled out now at that level. However, that's not to say it won't be rolled out in 2020 and beyond.
Okay.
Yeah, so we don't know.
We'll leave it there. Yep. Okay. Amazee, Neil, thanks for coming in today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.